Hello everyone, welcome again on my educational video.
Our today's talk will extend to the molecular mechanism for agrobacterium mediated plant genetic transformation. As I told you in introduction trailer, Agrobacterium is soil-borne gram-negative bacterium and belongs to the same family that of rhizobium. There are many species of the Agrobacterium. I have enlisted few of them along with the name of their discoverer and year of discovery. However, only two species are important to use as a tool to transfer certain gene in plants, the tumefaciens and rhizoceans. Agrobacterium tumefaciens is a serious pathogen of grapevines, plum shrubs, mango trees, stone fruits, nut trees, sugar beets, horseradish, and rhubarb. It causes tumor induction in over 140 species of dicot plants. The tumor is called crown gall. Scientists have also been engineered to give infection to monocots, whereas rhizogenes induces hairy roots in the infected plants. This slide shows hairy root in a laboratory culture. Look at the morphological appearance of Agrobacterium tumefaciens cells under scanning electron microscopy. Here you can see how agrobacterial colony really looks like. Colony morphology in laboratory culture grown on LB agar media. The bacterium, Agrobacterium tumefaciens, is a natural genetic engineer of a wide variety of plants. The bacterium has a loop of DNA called a tumor-inducing or TI plasmid and can transfer a part of this plasmid into a plant cell. The DNA transfer induces plant cells to make food molecules for the bacterium by uncontrolled cell division. The agrobacterium, which is present in soil, infects plant at some site of injury. This wound site releases phenolic compound acetosiringone, by which agrobacterium detects the signaling for infection at injured site. The binding activate VIR-A protein, which in turn activate another protein called VIR-G through phosphorylation. A number of genes called VIR genes are located on TI plasmid, out of which the genes coding VIR-A and VIR-G are turned on all the time. The expression of other VIR genes are required VIR-G as transcriptional activator to activate it. Two of the gene products are VIRD1 and VIRD2. The VIRD proteins are endonucleases that cleave 25 base pair sequence repeats. Those are flanking tDNA. The cell produces single-stranded tDNA molecule that remain attached to VIRD2 at one end. VIRD2 directs the transfer of the tDNA into a plant cell and eventually into nucleus in a process similar to bacterial conjugation. Within the plant cell and nucleus, the tDNA gets integrated into genome. A number of genes are encoded in tDNA and become expressed in plant cells. Some of the gene products are responsible for synthesis of the plant hormones, cytokinin and auxin, which triggers plant cells to divide rapidly and form an undifferentiated mass known as crown gall tumor. tDNA also controls production of unusual amino acid derivatives called opines. In return for delivering a tDNA to plants, the bacterium gets opines as a source of nitrogen. Plant biotechnology researchers have prepared the agrobacterium to genetically engineer a wide variety of plants, including both monocot and dicot. In this procedure, the tDNA is placed on another plasmid that is more easily manipulated, and the DNA between the flanking regions repeat sequences is replaced by the gene of interest. Upon infection, the virulence system induces transfer of tDNA into the plant cell, allowing integration of recombinant gene without tumor induction or opine production.
That's all about the molecular mechanism of agrobacterium-mediated genetic transformation. Please like, share, and subscribe the video for more updates.